Hi, my name is Derek, and today I'll be taking you through the part release workflow and recommended best practices when using Formlabs Build Platform 2. I'll be going over tips and tricks for job setup in PreForm, then I'll demonstrate how to remove parts using Build Platform 2, and finally, I'll walk you through some cleaning best practices. Let's start with PreForm, the easy-to-use software that preps your design for 3D printing. If your part doesn't have any unsupported areas, consider printing it directly to the build platform. This will eliminate the need for supports, saving you time on post-processing. If supports are necessary, be sure to use full rafts with Build Platform 2, since mini rafts can be difficult to remove with the flexible surface and can result in support tips breaking off during release. It's important to orient your part so that the long edge of each part is perpendicular to the bend axis of the platform. Or, in PreForm, orient the long edge of your part parallel to the front of your build seam. This will help to ensure a successful part release since Build Platform 2 only bends in one direction. Please note that small parts, or parts that are less than 20 millimeters across, do not consistently release using Build Platform 2. These parts can always be removed using a scraper, or you can overlap rafts so that several small parts form one larger part. Once your print is finished, it's time to remove the parts from the build platform. There are several ways to do this, and today I'll show you two of the most common. For small parts, I typically hold the platform directly over a table and push each handle inwards. This allows the parts to fall directly onto the table. For tall, large, or heavy parts, I place the platform on its side, use one hand to actuate the platform, while I use the other hand to guide the parts off onto the table. For this print, I'll use the first method. I'll hold the build platform parallel to the table, push both handles inwards, and the parts will come off onto the table. After removal, there'll be some residual resin left on the build platform as well as under the flexible surface. If you're using the same resin for the next print, a quick wipe with paper towel and a bit of IPA is all the cleaning that's needed. The platform doesn't need to be perfectly clean. We just want to make sure that there are no bits of hard resin left on the build platform surface before the next print. If you're switching between resins or are not planning to print with the build platform for the next few weeks, you'll need to remove the print surface and clean all surfaces thoroughly. This can be done by removing the flexible surface from the build platform body. To remove the print surface, lift one handle off of the platform, then push up on the opposite handle. This will disengage the print surface from the build platform body. You'll notice that there's some residual resin under the print surface on the build platform body. This is normal and will happen with every print. This does not affect end part quality or print success, and only needs to be cleaned when switching resins or going several weeks without printing. I can now clean all surfaces of the build platform with paper towel and IPA. Alternatively, I can use a form wash to do the cleaning for me. I can put the flexible surface in the form wash basket and place the build platform body on the form wash forks. I can then send this down for a quick cleaning cycle to clean the build platform and the print surface. After cleaning, to reattach the print surface onto the build platform body, I'll use the print surface's alignment rod, which is on one side underneath the handle, to align the print surface onto the build platform's alignment channel, which is on one side of the build platform. And then I'll rotate the print surface down onto the build platform body. This should self-align the print surface, but you can flex and release the print surface to ensure that it snaps back into the correct position. Finally, I want to mention a new feature for our Form 3 series printer called Z-axis fine-tuning. This allows you to make fine adjustments to the height of the printer's first layer, which can help you tune your print settings and reduce issues like under-adherence or overcompression. Overcompression, for example, can result in a rim of excess material around the perimeter of your parts where the part is adhered to the build platform. You can find Z-axis fine-tuning on your Form 3 series printer under Maintenance, Calibration, Fine-tune Z-axis. For more information on this feature, visit support.formlabs.com. Build Platform 2 is a valuable tool that will streamline your 3D printing workflow. To learn more about our SLA 3D printing products, visit formlabs.com.